Good morning and welcome to the International Space Station Flight Control Room here in Houston, Texas, where you're joining us for ISS update on this Wednesday, April 4th. Currently, the Orbit 2 team is on console monitoring the systems on board the orbiting laboratory here in Mission Control, Houston. That team today is being led by Flight Director Tony Sakachi. Joining him at the Capcom position, serving as the voice command link between the controllers here on the ground and the crew in space, is Hal Getzelman. And right now, the Expedition 30 crew is hard at work on an array of science experiments and maintenance on board the station. And that crew, if you start in the front row on the left, is commanded by NASA astronaut Dan Burbank, and behind him are Russian cosmonauts Anton Shkaplerov and Anatoly Ivanishin. Further along on the back row, you have European Space Agency astronaut Andrei Kuipers, NASA astronaut Don Pettit, finally in the front right, Russian cosmonaut Oleg Kononenko. So as mentioned, the crew hard at work today on quite a few replacement activities for some of the systems on board the International Space Station. Commander Burbank spent a good part of his day earlier working on the station's attitude control system, global positioning system. You can see here him as he works alongside European Space Agency astronaut Andrei Kuipers to remove and replace that GPS system. It's part of the hardware that's used in sending navigation data and will be used in the upcoming SpaceX Dragon flight next month as the capsule flies within close proximity of the complex for grapple and berthing. Aside from that global positioning, remove and replace work, Commander Burbank was doing some weekly cleaning activities today just to keep the station in tip-top order. And moving on, we have Russian cosmonaut Anton Shkaplerov, who immediately after waking up today participated in the Russian Sprut-2 investigation, which looks into preventing any unfavorable impacts on how well the astronauts stay hydrated in that microgravity environment, and also how the fluid is distributed throughout the astronaut's body. Aside from that experiment, he'll be replacing a power supply unit in one of the air conditioners in the Zvezda service module, alongside his fellow Russian cosmonaut Anatoly Ivanishin. Ivanishin, meanwhile, did a physical fitness evaluation a little bit earlier on the treadmill. These astronauts are monitored very closely by doctors and flight surgeons down here on the ground to ensure that their health is being maintained throughout their long-duration space flights. Aside from that, he was also participating in an interactions experiment, which looks to study the behavior of a small group throughout their long-duration expeditions. The third Russian cosmonaut, Oleg Kononenko, was working on the pneumocard study today, which is a Russian study of the adaptation of the cardiovascular system of these crew members during those long periods spent in microgravity. He'll also, a little bit later today, be doing a urine transfer from some of the storage tanks on board the station to an empty water tank on the Progress vehicle currently docked to the station. European Space Agency astronaut Andrei Kuipers is also doing a little bit of weekly cleaning activities and, again, assisting Commander Burbank with that global positioning system remove and replacement work. He was also working on the nanorack platforms, doing a few reconfiguration activities on some of the modules, and getting some onboard training for the operation of the nanoracks Microscope 1 and 2. Then our final Expedition 30 crew member, NASA astronaut Don Pettit, was working with the VO2 Max experiment today. This is a system much like ones found here on the ground that looks to study aerobic capacity, and these astronauts participate in this study both before, during, and after their long-duration space flights to see how the microgravity environments, their aerobic capacity, and how well their circulatory system is working. He was doing some standard maintenance work on the ARED, the Advanced Resistive Exercise Device, greasing up some of the rails that help to ensure that its vibration, isolation, and stabilization system continues working. And then finally, he will be working on a very interesting study that is sponsored by the Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency that looks to study how plants sense gravity as an environmental signal and then use it for governing their morphology and growth orientation.